Le schéma à l'écran représente un aménagement type.
The graph on the screen is the standard layout for a hydraulic power plant. We're going to detail the drawing. We see the dam, first of all. This is the essential component of a hydraulic power plant. The dam is across the river, and it creates a lake. We also have the drawdown zone, the variation of the level depending on the operating mode for the turbine. Water is then derived into an intake pipeline, which could also be a gallery dug directly into the ground. There could be a penstock pipe that drives the water directly into the power plant where the turbines are found. And when the water leaves the turbines, it goes through an outlet canal directly into the river, and the river is sent back into the river. Between the dam and the junction with the outlet canal, there is a short-circuited section. Now, this short-circuited section plays an essential role because it must always receive a reserved flow, which is necessary for local fish life, for water life, and also to feed the surrounding aquifers. It is absolutely essential that the dam is made in such a way that the water can continue flowing when the power plant is stopped, or when the dam reservoir is full, or when there is more water going into the system than can be processed by the plant. Now, if we look more closely at the system, we see the dam, which is across the river. There could be a very small dam here. We have, for instance, the Jouques Dam, a wall of less than 2 meters in height, but on the right-hand side, so the left side of the picture, there is a gallery going straight into the mountain to feed the power plant. The Girotte dam in the mountains in the Savoie area is very big. It's made of multiple arches. Most dams in France are concrete dams, but made with different technologies. The first one you see on the left is a roller compacted concrete. It's a wall built in successive layers of concrete being compacted, and it is the weight of the wall that will oppose the pressure exerted by the water. There are also arch dams. The one in the middle is the Sainte Croix dam, relatively narrow, but the pressure of the water on the dam is forward to the mountain, and it is the connection between the concrete and the mountains that provides resistance to the water pressure. The arch theory can also be implemented with a multi-arch dam, no longer resting on the rocks, but on pods. Here we have the Miguelou dam in the Pyrenean Mountains on the right-hand side of the picture. The water reservoir is held by a multi-arch dam. There are also weight arch dams, a combination between the concrete dam that we see at the top and an arched dam. Here we have the Dordogne River, where the dam opposes the pressure, and at the same time, the water pressure is also transferred to the two embankments. If we have low head dams on the Rhône or Rhine River, there are pods being built into the river, and each pod is connected by a vein which is opened or closed depending on how much flow is needed. Another kind of dam, the embankment dam, which oppose the water pressure, and most of the time these fill-in embankment dams are made from waterproof material, either a clay core at the center of the dam, or a waterproof membrane which is placed on the upstream side of the dam. Here we have the biggest dam in France, probably even the biggest in Europe, the Serponçon Dam in the Alps Mountains. So we said there was a penstock pipe, which could be a gallery. going through the mountain, or if it is granite, the gallery could be made of granite, or it could be coated after drilling.
The
inside of the gallery will be coated in concrete. After the gallery, we have a penstock pipe, most of the time made of steel. However, currently, synthetic materials are being used more frequently, although only for relatively limited head, maximum 100 meters.
Le cœur de l'aménagement
hydroélectrique. Here we have the core of the hydroelectric plant, the turbine, and depending on the head, the turbine type is entirely different. If we're talking about high head systems, the turbine will be of the Peltom type, left-hand side picture, turbines rotating in the air and that are only pushed by the water jet hitting them. If the turbine is inside the housing so that water doesn't get sprayed everywhere, but one needs to remember that the push is exerted by the water on directly on the turbine, a bit like the small windmills we used to build in rivers when we were children. For intermediate head water plants, we have the Francis type turbine. The turbine is immersed and it operates in an entirely different way. It is a reaction type of operation. The water pressure pushes the blade, which are oriented in such a way that they actually create torque on the motor. For very low heads, we have Kaplan type turbine, Francis turbines with only four or five blades, which can be oriented depending on the flow. The blade will be oriented the same way that it would be on a helicopter in order to improve yield. Here we see the cross section of a hydraulic power plant. Generator, this is a Francis turbine. We see the intake pipe around the turbine. We also see the shaft, which drives the alternator. The alternator rotor, the alternator produces a magnetic field which excites the stator, and we can see the water coming in from the left-hand side, going around the turbine and then down into the suction system.